And it seems like Bitcoin bubble is about to get burst. Bitcoin is trading down nearly 6% at around $3,500 a coin amid mounting reports of a crackdown on digital coin by Chinese regulators. Reports last week said that Chinese regulators would require exchanges to voluntarily shut Bitcoin trading, triggered sell-off, bringing the price of cryptocurrency below $3,000 for the first time in over a month. Now, within hours, however, Bitcoin recouped most of those losses, and many Bitcoin enthusiasts don't view the crackdown as a significant problem as it doesn't affect the cryptocurrency. And US bank CEOs are also, we say that they are criticizing Bitcoin, saying they are very afraid. In fact, JP Morgan CEO went ahead and said that it's a fraud, and whosoever is found having any dealing in cryptocurrency would be fired from JP Morgan. That's how situation bad is there. As far as we can say that this is concerned, the cryptocurrency is concerned. And we are joined by our tech correspondent Sahil Manikatla on the whole. More for this. Sahil, well, you have been tracking this from some time. So is it really, you know, a time when Bitcoin is going to be, there's no future for Bitcoin, because we have seen it going to $5,000, we reported then, and back to $3,500. So it's plunging, and do you think there's still future for it?
Well, China's decision to clamp down on Bitcoin has naturally sent shockwaves across the virtual currency markets, you know, throughout the globe. You know, this doesn't really come as much of a surprise. Since it's happened, since China's decision to do that, Bitcoin's value has fallen by one third of its original value, which is actually an indicator of China's strength in the virtual currency market. Now, Bitcoin uses something called blockchain technology, which means governments can't really regulate it. And China doesn't like that. China, of course, wants to tighten its control over Bitcoin, the virtual currency. Of course, which means going forward, companies operating using Bitcoin will no longer be able to raise finance using that currency anymore. Which is actually ironic, because Bitcoin was considered to bring this new world order, this new monetary system that was supposed to challenge the traditional establishments. But that doesn't seem to be the case anymore, because 2017 has been one of the worst years for Bitcoin transactions.
In the meantime, we should take a look at another story where, after facing heat in China with authorities, they're regulating trading of cryptocurrency Bitcoin. It has come under the lens of authorities in India too. Investments in cryptocurrency have come under the radar of tax authorities and investigating agencies amid concerns that they could have become conduits for illegal flows and movement of black money. So concerns over Bitcoin use are there for facilitating black money. India has also cracked a whip on Bitcoins, and reports say the special investigation team, or SIT, on black money has expressed concerns about cryptocurrency. SIT has also suggested curbs on their trading in its draft report. The authorities are looking at the issue closely and are expected to take a call shortly, but so far India has not yet taken a call on how it wants to treat cryptocurrencies. So back to Sahil. Sahil, if we talk to you about how cryptocurrency Bitcoin can be used for black money movement, can you help us explain that?
Well, it's very difficult to track Bitcoin. I mean, drug dealers use it a lot. The dark web, you know, that's the preferred currency, Bitcoin. You know, you want to buy drugs, you want to buy weapons. That's the currency that people will be using to, you know, transact with. But, you know, the future of Bitcoin, it's hard to say, because Bitcoin as a protocol will always evolve. But that's the thing that people forget, that Bitcoin is simply a protocol, and that money will always be the first application. Bitcoin as a currency will be regulated in other countries as well, not just China, and government will tighten its control over it. And as that happens, Bitcoin will reduce its volatility going forward.
Okay, so I'll just stay with us. And reports are also emerging that Bitcoin industry may be heading for another split or fork in November. The opposing groups involved in cryptocurrency's blockchain are unable to come to a consensus on the way forward as far as handling the growing number of transactions occurring in the network are concerned. It was only in August that network had split, leading to a main Bitcoin and another version, which came to be known as Bitcoin Cash. This split increased the size of network, but it also meant that some of the miners and traders moved to Bitcoin Cash, and the main Bitcoin network did lose out their resources. So second group, SegWit2x, is pushing for another split, and Bitcoin split can happen as early as in the next 2 months.